Justice Lokur, my esteemed colleagues in the Supreme Court, Mr. Arun Chawla, Mr. N.J. Khaitan, Dr. Sanjay Babaj Nasparu, ladies and gentlemen. While introducing me, it has been told, initially I was elevated as the Chief Justice of Patna High Court, then I came to Delhi High Court as the Chief Justice. It has something to do with arbitration. That is why I am commencing my address from there. When I came to Delhi High Court, I found that Delhi High Court had a court-annexed arbitration or court-adjunct arbitration. An agreement had been entered into by my predecessor with certain public sector undertakings and certain other commercial organizations. I was not in favor of it because the premises were situated in Delhi High Court itself. As a constitutional court and under the constitution, you really can't let out a premises situated in the High Court to private parties. So we changed the rule and made it absolutely court annexed arbitration. On consent of parties, we sent there and nominated the arbitrators. It's different. Many high courts in the country had this court annexed arbitration. While talking about court annexed arbitration, I must say I am in favor of institutional arbitration like ICA, MCA, and whatever they are having throughout the country. There are arbitration centers in Mumbai. There are arbitration centers in Delhi like ICDR and the present one where I have come. And there are arbitration centers in Indore and other commercial places. And I must say, they are doing extremely well. The shift has to be towards institutional arbitration. There is a need and there is a purpose. When you are handling a complex economy, there has to be a structural adjudication of disputes. While I was a student of school in a different place, the vice chancellor of the university had come to address the college students, and as a school student, I had gone to attend that. The vice chancellor was a professor in economics. His first sentence was, "The whole economy of a nation is based on trust. Trust is the spine of the economic growth. No trust, growth of economy is a mirage. You can't achieve it." Despite the concept of growth being emphasized upon, regarding her to the human nature, there is bound to be disputes. It's not the human nature alone, but the commercial perceptions, the clauses in the contract, and the swings in the business compulsorily sometimes attract arbitration. In United States of America, United Kingdom, and other progressive countries, they have realized, and we have also realized, that the best way to solve these commercial disputes are not the court litigation. I'm not talking about court adjunct arbitration, but the litigation in courts. Therefore, there has to be alternative dispute resolution system. As far as the national scene is concerned, the alternative dispute resolution system has gained primacy. Arbitration is one of them. And as has been told by Mr. Chawla, there is also emphasis on mediation. We are not going to any other aspect because the commercial disputes can only be solved through mediation or arbitration, and today we are focusing on arbitration. As far as the international disputes are concerned, or when I say international disputes are concerned, it means international disputes, that is commercial disputes at the international level. They are to be solved through what you call international alternative dispute resolution mechanism. We have to grow into that. We can't be a frog in the well or a cocoon. We have to adjust. But when we adjust, we don't surrender our conceptual sovereignty. And that is where India has to try to grow to have its own arbitral system, an arbitral system so that the people from other jurisdictions get attracted to have arbitration proceedings in India if they intend to do business in India. I have been told the foreign investments are coming to India. The percentage is getting higher day by day. There have been some billions, now it has gone to 16 billions. I'm not there. You also do business outside. But sometimes the agreements are so drafted that the concept of jurisdiction shifts from India to outside. That's your choice. Nobody can impose a contractual choice on you. But if you are really doing business, you must also look after the interest of the country. You may say the arbitration is not cost effective, and as the phrase was used, I mean, there I don't agree, I'll correct him. There should be a friendly judicial approach and government support. It's not friendly judicial approach, but what he means to say and what he conveys, I must transcreate it. Minimum interference and maximum executability. If you get an award in your pocket and it becomes a paper tiger, it's useless. An award which is executable is meaningful. And that is where the concept of less interference and maximum realization come into play. You see, let's travel in a time machine. Under the 1940 Act, the scope of interference was almost zero, unless you come within Section 30 and 33 of the 1940 Act. But that really led to some kind of economic anarchy, because the people who were not, who did not deserve the award, got the award. The state legislatures amended the law, created arbitral tribunals. The Supreme Court said reasons had to be given. The law fluctuated, law flexible at times. Then the onset on model came, keeping in view the international concept. Then also, the court thought, that's the beginning, why can't we have the jurisdiction over the arbitration proceedings in foreign countries? And that you know.